Honorable Member Sri Kalyan Banerjee.
Sir, thank you, sir, for giving the chance to speak on this bill, the Narcotic Drugs and Psychotropic Substances Amendment Bill 2021. Sir, in a catena of judgments, the Supreme Court has said in civil cases or criminal cases excepting taxing statute, no provision can be given a retrospective effect. This is settled principles of law. Despite that, it has been brought. Future days will decide whether these types of provisions are ultra-virus or not. Since they are having the majority, they'll get it passed through, but it is not final here. Final arbiter of the interpretation of a statute or the constitution is the Supreme Court. That will be tested. Sir, I am coming to different parts of this act since this act has come. When a person is arrested with contraband involving commercial quantity according to the provision of Section 37 of the NDPS Act, no court shall grant bail unless satisfied that there is reasonable grounds for believing that he is not guilty of such offence. If this is the provision, coming to such a finding for a court of law before recording evidence is next to impossible. Next to impossible. Sir, offence relating to narcotic and drugs all over the world considered to be more serious. It need not it debate that by introducing drug addictions amongst young generation, the future of a nation can be silently killed without nuclear weapons. But the issue involved is nonetheless less important. Many a times persons are booked and arrested, although either from search of their person or their place of residence, no drug or psychotropic substance is seized. Those persons are arrested merely on the alleged statement of the principal accused from whose direct possession such drugs are seized. It would not be out of place to mention that law permits the police to record statements of the arrested accused while in police custody, but does not permit to use an evidence during trial. Sir, Section 37 of the Act is per se, it is a draconian. In view of the additional limitation it implies over and above the limitation of bail as envisaged in the Code of Criminal Procedure of 1973. The biggest fetter it mandates while dealing with an application for bail is indicated in Section 37(1)(b) Roman II of the NDPS Act. Inter alia, so far as commercial offences involving commercial quantity is concerned. Legislation mandates the said provision that where a public prosecutor opposes the application, the court is satisfied that there are reasonable grounds for believing that he is not guilty of such offence and that he is not likely to commit any offence on bail. This is impossible at the threshold without recording evidence. Such position of legislation clearly cast a doubt on its operation, inasmuch as it practically wants cognizance of offences taken by the court of the first instance, wherein an accused have been indicated to have committed an offence in the police report than in such circumstances. It would be virtually impossible for the state court to grant bail to the accused persons. Sir, such a rigorous parameteria provisions were engrafted in the PMLA Act, and the Honorable Supreme Court of India in Nikesh Tarachand Shah versus Union of India in 2017 held on a similar situation, similar provision, held is ultra-virus and it really contravening Article 14 and Article 21 of the Constitution of India. This is, sir, I just quote that 2018 11 Supreme Court cases, page 1, at paragraph 43 and 46. Similar type of provisions have been declared ultra vires. The concept of presumption of culpable mental state, as envisaged in section 35 of the NDPS Act, is also draconian, as the statutory presumption requires the court to presume the mens rea of knowledge, intention or reason to believe. Under this section, the presumption is a rebuttable one. The burden of proof is on accused to prove that he did not have the requisite culpable mental state. The same is an anathema to the basic concept of the criminal jurisprudence and practice in the country. Sir, that there are 35 read with section 37 makes it extremely difficult for a person to be released on bail. Thereby, right to life under Article 21 of the Constitution of India is taken away. If anyone gives a statement that I have brought from him, accused is giving a statement, then whose name is there? He will be arrested. And he will not get the bail. Not getting a bail itself is a violating of Article 21. What is the law? Law is that bail is normal, jail is exception. Including the last one is the Arnab Goswami and Chidambaram case. The Supreme Court have said that things. Very recently it has been said. Repeatedly, it was the first Justice Krishna Iyer said in 1977 at 78. This is the line of Justice Krishna Iyer. Therefore, sir, report of arrest and seizure as envisaged in Section 57 of NDPS Act mandates that a full report of particulars of the same has to be made over to the immediate superior officer. The said compliance has to be understood and read with Section 51 of the NDPS Act and should be placed together with the same. Sir, we have seen that, sir, law in our country enough. So many laws are there, there's no difficulty. The question of the applicability of the act by the persons concerned. I am not blaming any government. I am blaming the officers who are implementing and introducing it. We know that in so many cases, when no case has been made out to arrest someone, some ganjas are kept in the car or some ganjas are kept in the pockets and he is arrested, or case is made out, although no seizure has been made. This is the case made out. Where from the ganja is coming, where from these things are coming, nothing is there. Therefore, sir, while addressing this bill, I am requesting the Honorable Minister to revisit the provisions which I have said that already, which I have said 37(1)(b) and etc. That's these provisions can be amended or not, especially in view of the recent judgments of parametria clause of the Nikesh Tarachand Shah's case. Their judgment delivered by Justice Norriman. Sir, we hope this act should not be misused, not abused by the machineries. That is the problem of this act, nothing. There is no reason to oppose the object of the act. No reason to oppose the object of the act. This act is no doubt necessary with certain modifications. And what is the caution has been taken under the act itself to control over these officers who have been empowered with the prosecution, investigation, and etc. Thanks, sir, for giving me the chance to speak.
Thank you. Thank you.